So we're back with more on secondary dominance. Last time we talked about all the theory behind it, so today we're talking about how to put it into practice, and we have a bunch of examples to go over. First, we're going to look at and go over spelling. Here we are, C sharp minor is the key. We want a 5-7 of 6. First, let's start by putting in our key signature. C sharp minor is the same as E major, which means 4 sharps. 5-7 of 6. Here's how I would do this. First, I'd say, what is 6? 6 would be A. I don't even need to know the chord, I just need to know the note. So then I have to say, well, what's a fifth above that? That's E. So E is the root of my chord. So I can then E build a major minor 7, E, G sharp, B, D natural. Notice I have to put in the natural sign because that's changing it from the diatonic key. If we don't put an accidental, you know you did something wrong because we're talking about secondary dominance. These are chromatic chords. Chromatic means there needs to be an accidental. No accidental means you're in the key. So let me say that again. For step one, I see where it's supposed to resolve to, 6. I find out what letter that is in my key. I then go up a perfect fifth. That's going to be the root of my 5-7 chord. I then spell it E, G sharp, B, D. Since this one's in root position, I don't need to do anything other than that. C minor, step one, key signature. Same thing as E flat major, 3 flat, so B flat, E flat, A flat. Here, again, I'm going to a 6 chord. In this case, A flat, up a fifth, E flat. So I spell myself an E flat major minor 7 chord. When it says 4-3, that's second inversion. So if I spell the chord, E flat, G, B flat, D flat, in this case I'm going to spell it down here because I want to put the lowest note as the fifth of the chord, which is what 4-3 means. So I start with the B flat, because that we're talking second inversion, then D flat, and I have to add that accidental, E flat, G. And then I have my 5-4-3 of 6 in the key of C minor. We go to A flat major. My key signature is 4 flats, B flat, E flat, A flat. Oops, let me do this in the appropriate clef. So B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat, 5-6 of 5. 5 is E flat. Fifth up is B flat. It's just a triad in first inversion. Triad B flat D F. When it says a 6, that means first inversion. So D is my lowest note. I need to put the natural in to negate the flat in the key signature. I then put my F and my B flat. And I have my 5-6 of 5. So that's a quick review on how you can spell the different secondary dominant chords. The other aspect of that, once you've done the spelling, going from a Roman numeral to a the notes you need, you also have to be able to go from the notes, from the pitches, to a Roman numeral. And that's what these three are going to ask you for. So here, it says E minor, and we get the notes E, G sharp, B, D. G sharp is not in the key of E minor. This is a major minor 7, an E7. I'm going to put in the lead sheet symbol as my step one. E7, that means I go down a perfect fifth to figure out where it's going to. Down a perfect fifth from E is an A. A in the key of E minor is the fourth scale degree. 4 is minor in a minor key. Let me do that step process again, because these are the questions you want to ask yourself. We have a major minor 7. We know we're talking about, I analyze this, it's major minor 7, so I write the E7 lead sheet symbol. It's not in the key, so I know it's a secondary dominant. I go down a perfect fifth from E, and I find out that the note is A. I then ask myself, what is A in the key of E minor? The answer is the 4 chord. The 4 chord is minor in a minor key. So this would be a 5-7 of 4. And that's how you would provide the Roman numeral analysis. Let's do another one. Here, our key is G minor. And something is not right with this. There's, let me put that natural there. If we have this natural, this is A, C sharp, E, G, which would be an A7. A7 in the key, so A7, then we say A, go down a fifth, would be D. D is what in the key of G? The answer is 5. 5 is major. So this would be a 5 chord of 5. It's in second inversion. A, C sharp, E. So we put 4-3. So 5, 4-3 of 5. If we go to our next example, right here, D major, looking at the pitches, I have D, E, G sharp, B, or E, G sharp, B, D. That is an E7 chord. So E, go down a perfect fifth, would be A. A is 5 in the key of D. So this is a 5. We have an inversion here. The D is in the bass, that means it's in third inversion. So 5. 4-2 of 5. Now, I'm not going through all the processes on how you figure out what inversion is. That's been talked about before. So if that's something you want to refresh, you can go back and look at how you figure out 6-5 as first inversion of a seventh chord, 4-3 second inversion of a seventh chord, 4-2 third inversion of a seventh chord. And one of the challenges is as we get more and more complex as we move forward in music theory is to make sure that you have those foundational things memorized. Because as we're doing these steps, if you have to figure out each step kind of from scratch, it's just going to take so long you're going to get lost. So, review as needed. We talked about how to spell the chords from the Roman numerals. We talked about how to get the Roman numeral from the spelling. Let's move forward and look at this, where we have a secondary dominant that is given to us. Our first step is to analyze it both in lead sheet and in Roman numeral analysis form. So we'll start with this. The pitches are from bottom to top, B, D, G, F. G is the root of the chord, so this is a 5-7 chord, but it is not in root position. We'll see that the B is in the bass. The B is the third of the chord. So this would be 6-5. So this will be a 5-6-5. We don't know of what yet, because we haven't figured that out. But if G is the root, that means down a fifth is going to be the of part. So down a fifth from a G is a C. C is what in the key of G minor? G, A, B flat, C. It is a 4. So this is a 5-6-5 of 4. Lead sheet symbol, G7 over B. I don't have to put the natural in for lead sheet symbols. Lead sheet symbols do not require things to negate what's in the key signature. So I can just write G7 over B. And it's assumed to be natural. So, the next thing we have to do is provide a chord that precedes and a chord to resolve. The easiest thing to start with is actually the resolution, because 5-6-5 of 4 is going to resolve to 4. So we need a 4 chord here. Now, is that going to be 4 in root position? Let's find out. Well, that means we need to go to a C. Can we move from a B natural smoothly to a C? Yes, very naturally, very smoothly as well. So we get our our C natural right there. We then have to do the rest of the things we need to do to resolve. That was our temporary leading tone, and I'm going to use the word temporary leading tone to refer to secondary dominance where 5-6-5 is resolving to 1 in the key of C minor here, so this is B natural, is a temporary leading tone. It resolves up by step, that's as expected. The seventh of the chord is the F, that should resolve down by step. I then need the notes C, E flat, G, two C's because I want to double the root. So I'll double the root here, moving by step, and I'll keep the common tone. Lead sheet symbol will be C minor. Now, what comes before a four chord? I don't have to ask myself what comes before a 5-6-5-4. This chord is being inserted into a traditional harmonic progression. So the question I have to ask is, what chord comes before a four chord? There's a bunch of options. I'm going to go with 2. So a 2 chord, in this case it would be 2 diminished. Since it's diminished, that tells me right away I probably don't want it to be in root position. Let's see if this is going to work out for me. So 2 diminished would be A, C, E flat, right? So if I go from a C, does that move nicely going to that B natural? Yes, by a half step. I'm going to have to be careful here with what I choose, because I can't just put any note representing any bass note for any chord. So, for example, a 6 chord would make sense. But if I put a root position 6 chord, I'm going E flat to a B natural. That's going to be an augmented interval. And those types of augmented intervals are very dissonant. So I can't do that. The rules of voice leading still apply. You can't have diminished or augmented leaps. Or there's a few exceptions, but in general, you want to avoid those, just like you avoid the leaps of an augmented fourth or a diminished fifth. So I'm looking specifically for what can move smoothly into and out of that. So my 2 chord is going to be A, C, E flat. In the key of G minor, I'm going to double the C because it's a diminished triad. So maybe I can kind of do something that's super close to what this was. If I put the A here, the E flat here, so I have two C's, A and E flat, and then I say for my lead sheet, A diminished over C. That would be a very elegant solution. Let's hear what that sounds like. Our key is G minor. Start with the 2 half diminished 6. We wouldn't stop there, of course. I just made us go back to G minor. But this is a nice way to kind of extend 2 diminished 6 to 4. Actually, I misspoke. 2 does not normally go to 4. It goes the other way around. So what would be a better choice? What would be a better choice than that? That's kind of a little bit of a retrogression. So instead of going there, we look at our harmonic progression. We know that 3, 6, 2 diminished, 4 are in the same kind of grouping. 4 goes to 2. 5, 7 is in that same dominant category. 7 can go back here. So before, and now let me do it correctly there. So normally, before 4, a 3 can leap like that, so that actually might be a good choice. What if we did that instead? Let's put up our B flat, our D, F, B flat. Yeah, I like that better. So that's even better for harmonic progression. because three always goes to four. What I had before, two diminished six, that would be a retrogression. So that's not as good. You'll find those retrogressions, but we don't want to make those the norm. Let's hear what this would sound like.
G minor.
We go to the three chord. And that actually is really neat because you get this in the bass, which is very forward motion. So one thing to keep in mind, even when I accidentally wrote the two diminished six, it sounded nice, the voice leading was good, but it didn't have the forward motion that this chord progression does. And that's typically what happens, is the reason you have certain chord progressions is to have that forward motion. Let's look at another example, right here. So we have A, D, F sharp, and C. So this is D is our root. That is our third. F sharp is our third. A is the fifth. C is the seventh. It's a D7 chord. D going down a fifth would go to the note G. G is five in the key of C. So this would be a 5, 4, 3, a 5. Because it's in second inversion, we have the A and the bass. That means we want to go to a 5 chord after that, and 5 would be G and the bass. And that moves very smoothly, voice leading, so I don't need to worry about putting that 5 chord in an inversion. And I can go to 5 as a triad. I could also go to 5-7. And let's make this as accurate as possible. We'll make sure it's D7 over A. We're going to go to a 5-7. We want the seventh of the chord to resolve down by step to a B. We need the notes G, B, D, F. This is our temporary leading tone, the F sharp. Normally we want that to resolve up, but there's a common exception. That exception is when you're going to another seventh chord right after it, that temporary leading tone usually resolves down instead of up. And that's what we need to do here. This D can be our common tone. So we get our G, we have our D, we have our B, we need the F natural. So the F sharp goes down a half step to the F natural. Here, we can say, what do we want to precede a 5-7? So, 2-6, in this case, would be perfect, because the progression is 2-6 to 5-7. The notes in a 2-6 chord, we need D, F, A. F is in the bass. So we put F in the bass. I'll put the D here because I want to set up my seventh nicely. I'll put the A here and I'll double that D. So I can have common tones straight across. That means this is a G7. This is a D minor triad over F in the bass. Let's hear what that would sound like. Our key is C major. We start with our 2-6 chord. And I will resolve it to you so you're not left unresolved. Okay? So that's another great example of how we can keep that progression moving forward, 2-6 to 5-7, but we insert the 5-4-3 of 5 to give some extra motion, some extra intensity, some extra direction. Here, 3 going to 4, a common progression. We put 5-6-5 of 4 and develop this chromatic ascending bass line. Excellent, excellent. So, the next step in our studies is to take a look at a figured bass example and realize the figured bass, providing us with, start off with a Roman numeral analysis. We got a lot of numbers with a lot of extra symbols here. So let's talk about these. Our key, we have three sharps. It's either F sharp minor or A major. Starts on F sharp, ends on F sharp minor it is. So, an F sharp with nothing written underneath it, that means root position triad. One chord. Here we have a C sharp with a seven and a sharp. The sharp refers to the third above the bass. Whenever you have an accidental with no number next to it, it means the third above the bass. So C sharp, root position seventh chord. Well, C sharp is five. This is not a secondary dominant. This is a primary dominant. This would just be 5-7. You'll notice I do not recopy the sharp down into the Roman numeral analysis. That's only for the figured bass. Here, we get something that's a little unusual. We have 6-5 with a natural, which means the fifth above the bass is turned into a natural. And then we have a natural, meaning the third above the bass is natural. So, let's do this step by step so that there is no confusion. The pitch in the bass is a C sharp. It's asking for a 6 above the bass. That would be an A. We just go diatonic, unless otherwise indicated. We're asked for a 5th above the bass, but natural. So 5th would be a G. G sharp is in the key signature, but they tell us G natural. So we put a G natural. And then a third above the C sharp, natural. Okay? So that would be E. Now, the reason I'm pausing here is it's a little unusual because E is what we would expect from the diatonic scale. Why put the natural in there? Probably just as a reminder. When we talk about an A7, which is what this is, A, C sharp, E, G, A7. It's a major minor 7, so secondary dominant should leap to mind because there's no G naturals in this. So it's a 5-5-6-5. Again, I do not copy down the natural signs. A is the root, go down a fifth would be D. D is what in the key of F sharp? It is a 6 chord. 6 is major, so I make it an uppercase Roman numeral 6. So I analyze it, 5-6-5-6. That's good. We then go to 6. That makes a ton of sense. That's one way you can check yourself. If you start writing secondary dominants and they don't resolve to, if this were to be 5-6-5-6 and it goes to something other than 6, you might want to check yourself. Here we have another. We have a 6-4-3. This is second inversion of a seventh chord. Let's see if it's a secondary dominant. So, we go back to our C sharp in the bass. We have a 6 above the bass, which is an A, but it has a slash through it, which means it's raised, but turns into A sharp. We have a 4 above the bass, that is F sharp. The sharp comes from our key signature. We have a 3rd above the bass, which is an E. So we have F sharp, A sharp, C sharp, E. This is my root, 3rd, 5th, and 7th. This is an F sharp 7. F sharp 7, go down a fifth, I go to a B. B is what in the key of F sharp minor? It is the 4 chord. 4 is minor in a minor key. So I know that this is a 5-4-3-4. And do I go to 4? There's a B with nothing written underneath it? Absolutely, I go to the 4 chord just as expected. So far, everything is making complete sense. Let's try this right here. Here we get to a 5-4-2. Our lowest note is a B. We need a fourth above that. That would be E, asking for a sharp. Two above would be C sharp. The implied is the six, which would be G sharp. So that means C sharp is our root, E sharp is our third, G sharp is our fifth, that is our seventh. So this is a C sharp seven, it's a major minor seven. This is not a secondary dominant, this is a primary dominant. This is our traditional five chord. So one of the things that can be tricky, just because you see an alteration in the figured bass doesn't mean you're necessarily talking about a secondary dominant. It could be a primary dominant. All right, here we go to 1-6. First inversion triad. Here we have a G sharp with a 7. This means root position 7th chord. In this case, G sharp, B, D natural, F sharp are our notes. That would be a 2 half diminished 7 chord. So 2 half diminished 7, 5. Here we have a C sharp in the bass. This would be our 5-7. And finally going to our 1 chord. So that would be our Roman numeral analysis. So there's a couple tricky spots in here. When we get to, we'll highlight them. Right here is our secondary dominant, our 5-6-5 of 6, our 5-4-3 of 4. And then just recognizing that not all of the seventh chords are secondary dominants. Our 2 half diminished 7 is a diatonic seventh chord. Our 5-4-2 is considered a diatonic seventh chord, or really a primary dominant. Primary dominant. Now, how would you voice lead these seventh chords? Here's a voicing, F sharp, A, C sharp. We're going to a 5-7, which would be C sharp, E sharp, G sharp, B. So, let's try to keep things as smooth as possible. We know we need a B. Let's move this down by step to our B. Move this down by step to our well, we need our E sharp, so we have F sharp. We can go to E sharp right here. G sharp here. Let's see if this. Alright, so this works. Again, this is a little, is what I'm paying attention here. F sharp to C sharp is a perfect fifth. E sharp to B is an unequal fifth. If it went to an E natural, we'd have a problem. But this is okay. We then said that right here is an A7 chord. C sharp in the bass. So, there's my C sharp. This E sharp normally would like to go up a half step to resolve. The B wants to go down. So B will go down. This E sharp, however, the temporary, in this case, the leading tone, is not going to do what it normally does. It's going to resolve down, because we need to get an E natural. And the G will stay. Actually, the G will become a G natural. So we'll have the E sharp go down a half step, the G sharp will go down a half step, and the B will go down a step. We then go to here, which is a D major triad. The seventh of the A7 resolves down a step. We maintain a common tone, and we move the E by step to double the root. We then have our 5-4-3 of 4. This is going to be an F sharp 7. So here's an A. I'd like to move that right up to my A sharp. I'll keep this as my common tone. F sharp stays common tone. I need an E, so this will move to the E. Again, I'm going for super smooth voice leading, and so far, so good. I then need to go to my four chord, which is a B minor triad. A sharp is my temporary leading tone. I want to resolve that up. It's in an outer voice. There's B. I'll keep the F sharp as a common tone, and I'll put the E down to D. This is my 5-4-2. This is a C sharp 7 with B in the bass. So with that, let's have this move back up to C sharp. Is that going to work? Yeah. Actually, I'm going to think about it step by step. This F sharp will become my E sharp. That'll move up to my C sharp, yeah. Actually, no, I want to move to a G. So I'll move this D to the C sharp. I'll jump down to the G sharp here. Again, I'm looking for the smoothest voice leading. A leap of a third, that's no big deal. More than that can sometimes be problematic. The seventh resolves down. I can maintain a common tone here, a C sharp. I can move an F sharp here. What do I want to double? I could double that F sharp. I think that's what I'll do. Then I want my 2 half diminished 6-5, that is a G sharp, half diminished 7. So I'll maintain the F sharp. I'll put the B in the tenor, D in the alto. I need my C sharp 7. Let's have an E sharp here in the soprano. I can do a nice perfect authentic cadence. Keep the B there. I'll have an incomplete chord because I don't want to make my life harder. This makes it for very smooth voice leading. And the seven resolves down. All right, now let's double check to see if this actually works. Let's play it on the piano. Our key is F sharp minor. We start off with our one chord. Figured bass that had seventh chords, both diatonic seventh chords, primary dominants, and secondary dominants. We then utilized all of our voice leading rules dealing with resolving the seventh of a chord down by step, of paying close attention to the leading tone or temporary leading tone, trying to resolve that up when possible, resolving it down when necessary. So, secondary dominants. Another important skill to have is knowing how to harmonize a melody note and what options there are. So you can harmonize a melody note with diatonic chords, but you can also harmonize them with a secondary dominant. So if we are in the key of F sharp minor and our melody note is a C sharp, what are the possible secondary dominants that you can use to harmonize that note? So the way I do it is I first say, if that C sharp were the root, what are my options? If it was the third, what are my options? If it was the fifth, what are my options? If it's the seventh, what are my options? So, if this is the root, what are my options? Well, I have none, because then it's going to be a 5 chord or a 5-7 chord. That's not a secondary dominant. So, there's no secondary dominant where C sharp is the root in the key of F sharp minor. What about if it was the third? If it was the third, that means A would be the root. So A, C sharp, E. Well, A, C sharp, E is a 3 chord. So that doesn't work. But what about A, C sharp, E, G natural? An A7 would be, and that would be a 5-7 of 6. You'll notice that a 5 of 6 doesn't make sense, because a 5 of 6 would just be a 3 chord. But when you put that 7th in there, you get the G natural in the key of F sharp minor, you're definitely here, your ear will hear it be a secondary dominant. So what if this were the fifth? If this were the fifth, I could have an F sharp 7 or an F sharp major triad. If it's an F sharp major triad, then it is a 5 of 4. If it's a F sharp 7, it's a 5 7 of 4. So both of those are options to harmonize. What if the C sharp were the 7th? Well, if the C sharp's the 7th, then D sharp's the root. But D sharp can't go down a fifth to a major or minor triad because the two chord is half diminished. So you'll never have D sharp being the root in this key. Because remember, secondary dominants have to be able to go down a fifth to something that would be a major or minor triad. So here are my answers, right here. If I want to harmonize the pitch C sharp in the key of F sharp minor, and I want to give it some kind of extra spice, some extra interest, and I want to use a secondary dominant, I can use 5-7 of 6, 5 of 4, or 5-7 of 4. Now, let's take that same note, a C sharp, but change the key. We're now in the key of D major. What are our options? If the C sharp is the root, is that an option now? Well, a C sharp major triad, is that in the key? No. Can it go down a fifth to a note that would be a major or minor triad? The answer is yes, it would go down to a three chord. So we could have 5 of 3 or 5-7 of 3. Both of those are perfectly good options. And that's, again, if we're using the root, thinking that C sharp turns out to be the root of a secondary dominant. What if it's the third of a secondary dominant, like A, C sharp, E? Well, that's not a secondary dominant. A, C sharp, E is the primary dominant. So the third is not an option for generating secondary dominants in this key. How about as the fifth? So F sharp major triad, that certainly would be outside of the key. That would be a 5 of 6. We could also have 5-7 of 6. And here, if we had it as the seventh, that would mean D sharp was the root, D sharp would go to G sharp, G sharp's not in the key, so that's not an option. Okay? So that's how you would do that. And here we have 4 different options on how you could harmonize that. I guess the trick that I want to zero in on and make sure is clear is that part where if we say C sharp, that's the seventh. That means we're talking about a D sharp, F double sharp, A sharp. This would be our major minor 7 chord. That means it would resolve down a fifth to G sharp. But G sharp is not in our key of D major. So it's not an option. And that's how I'm eliminating some of those. In both cases, I'm eliminating things that are one, primary dominants, or would have to resolve to something that's not a major or minor triad in the key that we're designating as what key we're operating with it. So this gives you some additional options on how to harmonize a melody and how you can use some of these secondary dominants to do that.